If you all will stand for just a moment. And Teresa's walking in with Lincoln, and they're carrying Craig. You all may be seated. Thank you. Well, I wish I could say it's great to see you all. It is, but I hate that it's under this circumstance. For those of you that may not know me, my name is Gus Gastineau. I am Craig's cousin, brother cousin, friend, little pest. Wrestling partner, ragdoll, however you want to define me. Thank you all for coming out to show your support and your love for Craig. And it means a whole lot to all of us. And funerals are difficult. And unfortunately, they're meant to be. It's an occasion where we have to confront the loss of what's happened. And we mourn the loss of Craig, someone who was an awesome man, an awesome friend, brother, family member, bandmate, fill in the blank. He was indeed. And so, you know, there's a big Craig-sized hole left in a lot of our hearts. And today we come to mourn his loss, but also to celebrate his life and just the cool dude that he was. And so we'll all definitely feel the weight of this loss. So would you please join me as I pray? Lord, thank you for allowing us to gather here today to celebrate Craig. Lord, just as we begin this service, we ask for just the presence of the Holy Spirit to bring us peace and comfort. Lord, as we celebrate Craig, just mourn this loss. In Jesus' name, amen. So I'm going to take a moment to read the obituary. Sure. Yeah, if you hear your name called, please stand. Yeah, just so people can put a face. So in loving memory of Craig Stewart Gillespie, born on May 24th, 1992, and sadly departed on July 24th, 2023, we celebrate the life of a remarkable individual who made his mark in the world with a dash of wit and a passion for music. Craig's age at the time of his passing was 31 years old. Craig began his journey as a hardworking individual, spending his time at UPS on Industrial Avenue, where he expertly loaded semi-trailers with precision. But it was the realm of music where his true spirit soared, from playing in a metal band to honing his skills as a self-taught bass guitarist since eighth grade. Music became his ultimate passion. One of Craig's notable achievements was his involvement in the band Hexus alongside Dalton Easter, Jesse Bowman, who's not here today, the late Anthony Crumpton, who sadly passed, and together they forged unforgettable melodies that resonated with their audience. Later, Craig and Dalton joined Divine Treachery along with Jimmy and Alan, creating music that spoke directly to the souls of their fans. Craig's talent and dedication were further showcased when Divine Treachery released their album, Never Ending Cycle for the Suffering, on April 20th, 2019. The impact of his musical contributions will forever echo through the hearts of those who had the pleasure of witnessing his performances. In 2019, Craig embarked on a new musical endeavor, joining False Prophet with founding member Paul Ray. Scott, I won't mess up your last name. Thank you. And Kyle Lane. This opportunity allowed him to travel across states, rocking stages in Texas, Florida, Virginia, Georgia, and New York, fulfilling his dream of sharing his love for music with a broader audience. Beyond his incredible musical accomplishments, Craig was supported by a loving family and cherished friends. He was preceded in death by his father, Anthony Gillespie, as well as his grandfathers, Donald Stewart Sr. and Joel Gillespie, his grandmother, Juanita Gillespie, and his aunt, Donna Gillespie, his godfather, Blaine Stewart, and his cousin, Christopher Hare. Surviving Craig is his devoted mother, Teresa Gillespie, his grandmother, Georgia Stewart, his brothers, Gus Gastineau, and Marissa is my wife, and Jason Hurst, and his sister, Miranda Hurst. His uncles, Donald Stewart Jr., who's married to Janice, and Sid Stewart, who's married to Kim, his cousins, Tiffany, Jessica, Andrew, Matt, who's married to Melissa, Brittany, Tyler, Courtney, his aunt and godmother, Jackie, who's married to Steve, fairy godmother, fairy godmother. And then myself, Casey, who's married to Justin, his aunt Ellie, who's married to Dennis, and his aunt Kim Gillespie, and his uncle James Gillespie. Additionally, he leaves behind his cousins Anthony Briggs and Shane Bryant, as well as his godson Lincoln Holman. Craig's dearest companion for 6 years was his girlfriend Stormy Jones, who shared his adventures and supported his musical pursuits every step of the way. He also held a special place in his heart for his nieces and nephews, Lincoln, Robert, Gideon, August, Aurora, Landon, Christopher, Bailey, Haley, Madison, Bella, and Paisley. To honor Craig's memory, a service will be held at Living Way Church, located at 4433 Rehoboth Church Road in Greensboro. Let us gather to celebrate his vibrant spirit and the imprint he left on our lives. In his younger years, Craig graduated from Southeast High School in 2010. During his time there, he found joy in participating in football and wrestling, demonstrating his determination both on and off the field. Craig Stewart Gillespie, a man of unyielding passion and a vibrant spirit, will forever remain in our hearts. May his soul find eternal peace, surrounded by the echoes of his music, and may his memory serve as a reminder to follow our dreams fiercely. And so at this time, I would like to welcome Jessica and Matt, and they are going to sing a song for us.
Hello. Secret chord that Greg had played.
How was it? Oh my, started too soon. We'll start
over. I heard there was a secret chord.
Wait, is it different? I'm sorry. Okay. Can we start the song over? I'm sorry.
Love you, Craig.
How do we start this? I was just focusing on saying Craig's name the whole time.
I heard there was a secret chord that Craig had played, and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this. The first,
I forgot the words.
Minor fall, the major lift, the baffled king composing.
Forse sei un Dio sopra di noi, per quel che ne sappiamo poi, non so nemmeno come si pronuncia, ma luce.
You hear at night, it's not somebody who's seen the light, it's a call and it's a broken hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Sunny day. I've been around this world, yet I see no end. All shall fade to black again and again. This storm that's broken me, my only friend, yeah. In this river, all shall fade to black. In this river, ain't no coming back. Shall fade to black. Ain't no coming back. Withdraw my step away just to find myself. The door is closed again, the only one. That's broken me, my only friend. Yeah. In this river, all shall fade to black. In this river, ain't no coming back. In this river, all shall fade.
the road to hell. Along the way is paved with good intentions, so they say. And some believe that no good deed goes unpunished in the end, so it seems. So when the day comes and the sun won't touch my face, tell the ones who cared enough that I finally left this place that's been so cold. Look in my face, all the stories in will tell I can't erase. The road is long, just one more song, a little something to remind you when I so this is it. I say goodbye to this chapter of my ever-changing life. And there's mistakes, the path was long, and I'm sure I'll for them when I'm gone, when I'm
there's a lot to say. So I'll keep saying it again and again. Craig is one cool dude. I mean, looking at even his kid pictures, like some of the outfits in my kid pictures are just sheer embarrassing. Or, I mean, half of those pictures I'm in, I'm like, and Craig's just like, cool, you know? But man, I looked up to him. He was a man with class, with respect. If you were in a circle, you were a friend for life. And he loved you. He was a big man with a big heart. He worked hard. He played hard. And he loved hard. He was such a gentle giant, too. I mean, you look at Craig, you would think, like, from an outsider's perspective, I'm sure people were so quick to judge by the exterior. But goodness, what a man. He was an awesome big brother to me. He always took my crap whenever I wanted to wrestle, and then, you know, I never won. And then I would get upset about it for some reason, even though I knew, you know, my record was 0-1,000 against Craig. But it's gonna be hard to do a lot of things without him, and a lot of things that don't remind me, you know, that'll remind me of him. You know, and even it's just random stuff, like we took a beach trip recently, and, you know, I went to the beach for the first time with Craig and many times thereafter. And even just thinking of, like, silly stuff makes me cry, like seeing a big old pile of ketchup on a plate. And then just as a confession to you guys, you know, I don't listen to that heaviest stuff, but, you know, occasionally I'll listen to Animals as Leaders, if you guys know who that is. And I was listening to them, and it's just all instrumental. And there's just this heavy riff, and, like, I can't remember what that sign says in your house. You hear the music, but you feel the bass or something like that, right? And I felt it, you know, and it was like, yeah. But then it was just like, man, you know. And it's like, who cries to a hard song like that, something that's hard and fast? But, yeah, this is not easy. It won't be easy for a long time. And so, you know, I hope that you guys will continue to keep him in your memory, to continue to think of him, even in the small things. Just remember the impact that he left on you. And so I've invited a few people to share, and, you know, just to talk about Craig, share a story, however. And the first person that said yes to me was Seth Stone. So if you'll come up, buddy.
I wanted to get a close-up look of these bases here because this is really beautiful, Mom. Thank you. This is a terrible situation that brings us all together, obviously, but this is a great memorial. False prophet, guys, can I see who you are real quick? Man, you guys were probably really close with Craig, huh? Which one was he playing most right now? The wood one? That's kind of what I thought. That's tough. That's super tough. I'd love to meet you guys after this. But if anyone doesn't know me, my name is Seth Stone. And I may not have been, you know, I didn't see Craig a whole lot here recently. You know, for a number of years, I didn't see him very often, but he was always there if I'd pick up the phone and call him if I ever needed anything and some advice or just sometimes something funny would happen to remind me of him, and I'd just send him a meme or something. But in high school, I was around a lot with my mama. Much like Gus, I saw Craig as a big brother. I met him in ninth grade, and we played football, and we wrestled together. And much like Gus, so when we did wrestle, like, for the school, there's only a couple kids big enough to try to wrestle Craig. So it's me and Gus and Craig and Brandon Canoy, who might not be here tonight, but Brandon Canoy right there. I know I see you, boss. Weak side, man. But unlike Gus, I was 1 in 1,000 against Craig. One time I got him, y'all. But when I was looking for a couple of stories to tell you guys, a lot of them I didn't think was probably appropriate to say. And a lot of them, the minute details kind of have been lost with time because it's been a number of years. So I would like to just share a couple, two moments that were funny that will stick out. Moments, not stories. One was in ninth grade, he was driving me to a football practice from his house. I spent the night there before. It was the first time I spent the night on a school night somewhere because I was sheltered. But it's cool because I thought it was so cool that he could drive a 5-speed. His first vehicle was the truck. But he showed me Slipknot, and I'd heard Slipknot. And I might have even knew the song. I think it was Before I Forget, maybe, or something. But he actually, like, we listened to it a bunch of times, and he was like, listen to this. This is the bass. Listen to this. This is the, like, describe measure to me and, like, some things that I can listen to music differently now because Craig was in my life. And I appreciate him for that because I like music. And another time, so I don't know if y'all know this about Craig. Craig could listen to a song one time and then play it, I swear. And I didn't know this when this thing happened, but one of the first times we hung out, I was sitting on his futon, and anybody that knew Craig in high school or went over to the house knows exactly what I'm talking about. I was sitting on the futon, and we was playing Guitar Hero. And if you could imagine, this is Craig, you're all me. This is Craig looking up at the TV, playing, right? And he didn't play it like a guitar. He hit it with his fingers like a bass. So that was something that stuck out. But he's watching the TV, playing it. And I'm like, dang, this guy ain't missed none. This guy's killing it. And he stopped and looked at me and kept playing the song. Because remember, I didn't know how music worked, right? So when he looks at me, I know I was the first one to, like, fan out for him. Like, oh, my God, I can't believe it. But, so yeah, that was a moment I'll never forget with Craig. That was my brother. And, man, there's a million more things I could say, a million more things I practice saying. But, I guess I'm gonna stop right there and just reiterate what Gus said, because after that video, I think we all, even if you didn't know him that well, you know, he's pretty dang cool. Craig was pretty dang cool. Thank y'all.
So next up will be, are you guys sharing together? Come on up, Dylan and Dylan. The Dylans, the worst.
For y'all that don't know me, I'm Dylan. This is my wife, Dylan. Somehow I was fortunate enough to meet Craig early in sixth grade, and for some reason we just hit it off. And then I was fortunate enough for Mama Teresa to let me stay at her house so many times, and stay the night during school night, which wasn't really supposed to happen. But Craig was just, like everybody knows, he had a big heart. He was a big dude. It's hard to just imagine that he's gone, because he was a good guy. He didn't deserve that.
My name is Dylan, as he said before. I was introduced to Craig through Dylan, and so we kind of just have known, it's just like, I can't remember life without Craig in it. You know, like, it's just, we grew up together. So it's like 18 years. Me and Dylan will be together 18 years. So I've known Craig almost 18 years. He possessed a heart just full of kindness, generosity. I mean, he'd give you the shirt off his back. He'd give you anything he had. And just funny, just funny, funny, goofy guy. If anybody could put a smile on your face, it was Craig. He had a humble yet protective nature. I mean, just, he didn't stand a bully. And that just made everyone around him just feel welcomed, safe, and loved. He always made me feel part of the group. Like I said, me and Dylan been together almost 18 years. And then boys were thick as thieves back then. And, you know, some of us, so the girls in the group, you know, Craig always made us feel welcome and part of the group, part of the family. Mama and Papa Toast just always made all of us wild kids, just welcomed us into their homes, just made us feel cared for, fed us, loved us, and just raised us as if we were their own. I can remember so many pizza nights at Craig's house, and if you were lucky enough, you got to see him and Papa Toast play together, but a lot of times, you know, Craig would just play all night, and you would just get entranced just watching him play. And to this day, I will never see anybody headbang like Craig Gillespie. Like, there is just, no one else could do it that way. He introduced me to metal at a very young age and expanded my horizons in music, and I still listen to many artists that he showed me to this day. So there are so many stories of all of us growing up together, of us changing, evolving, and experiencing life together. I mean, we grew up together. We experienced a lot of things together, some first things together. The fun that we had and the laughs that we shared will be cherished in my heart and soul forever. His memory will live on, reminding us to embrace life, be kind to one another, and find joy in the simplest moments.
I just want to take a minute and ask if anybody will, can they keep in contact with Mama Teresa over the years and just tell her she's loving? She knows she's loved.
Mr. John Coble. Now, our pastor said, be weary of who you give a microphone to. No, I'm just giving you a hard time, man.
That stands true today, guys. Hey. This is, okay. I'm not used to using one of these. But yeah, like everybody said, Craig, he's awesome. He's awesome, and he's definitely unforgettable. And like, no matter what, he always looked awesome. And like, just thinking back, I can remember, like, there's two stories I remember about Craig that I could probably actually share in public. And that's maybe the fact that my better half now, if it weren't for Craig, then I probably would have never known her. We would have never have had a family. And without Craig saying, hey, dude, that girl Nikki on the bus likes you, I wouldn't be where I'm at now in life. Even though at the time I wasn't really worried about that girl Nikki on the bus. But thanks to Craig, I do. And then probably like the second story that's most memorable for Craig is the first time that he met my mom, because she was a taxidermist. And the first time that he had met my mother, she was coming out of her building that she did taxidermy in, and she was covered in blood, listening to Jingle Bells. And she said, oh, you must be Craig. And then I think Craig fell in love with Mom after that. He said, your mom's the coolest. I guess because, you know, seeing as we were like horror fans and stuff, she reminded him a lot of Leatherface. But Craig definitely was a big part in all of our lives. If we ever knew him in high school, growing up with him or anything, he definitely held a lot of us together and was a huge staple in our little group of people. Like, a lot of us wouldn't know each other if it weren't for him. And it's really been a blessing to even know who Craig was and to just have been able to spend time with Craig and to stay in and out of trouble with Craig. I don't know what I would do if I hadn't have met Craig. It was definitely an experience and a wonderful part of my life, a wonderful time. And to be able to spend time with you and Tony and Gus when he was little. It was really, really great. It was really great, and it was an awesome experience. It was a wonderful, wonderful time in my life that I'll never forget.
Thanks, Gus. I'm sorry. I'll try to do better, but I can't.
That's perfect. Thank you so much for sharing.
All right. Dalton Easter.
Unlike John, I know how to use a microphone. Probably shouldn't leave me with it too long, so I'll try to keep it short because I could talk all night. And I'm going to put my hat on because Craig would want me to have my hat on because I always have my hat on. I wrote a few things down, but I'm not going to talk a whole lot. I don't need to stand here and tell anybody how great or amazing or kind or loving or loyal or just fantastic and just superb that Craig was. Everybody in this room knows how awesome Craig was. That's why y'all sitting in here. And all my years of knowing Craig, I ain't never met nobody that said, I don't like that dude. Like, I have heard it about me. I've heard about a lot of my friends. I've heard about a lot of people say, I don't like that guy. Never Craig. Never once did I ever hear that. Through school, football, music stuff, you just couldn't help but love Craig. He just put off something, man. You know, it was just, and he was what everybody knows him to be, as like a protector. He took care of everybody. He looked after you. It didn't matter. He looked after me so many times because I'm stupid and I do stupid stuff. But Craig always would grab me and go, come on, let's go. You know, and I'm going to miss that. But, and I'm very thankful to have been a part of his life. I'm going to miss him terribly. He definitely was my best friend. I've only had two. I've had a lot of friends, but I've had two really good friends, and I've actually lost both of them. And it's tough. But, you know, if heaven had phones, I'd call Craig right now and chew him out. I'd chew him out. And he'd go, here you are calling fussing at me. And I'd say, yeah. And he said, you always got something to fuss about. I said, you give me something to fuss about, I'm a fuss. And he'd smile and laugh. But one thing I even told Mama, that the one thing I'm going to miss the most about Craig with me was when I was being my silly self and talking out my head and running my mouth, I'd look over and he'd be standing next to me and he'd roll his eyes. And I am going to miss him rolling his eyes at me so much. That was my buddy. I'm going to miss you, man. I'm going to miss you for a long time, forever. I ain't going to say much more. I love you, amigo. I'll see you again one day.
Mike Jones.
I'm not used to doing stuff like this, so y'all be patient with me. That's why I got Stormy to come up here with me. She got my back, so I'm gonna have hers. I met Craig when I was about 18, 10 years ago, at UPS. And a lot like Dalton, I'm glad I'm not the only stupid one he had to look after. I hadn't been introduced to a lot of things in the world before I met Craig. He was the exemplification of not judging the book by its cover. I was always taught in my family, long hair was not meant for men, tattoos weren't very welcome, and it was intimidating meeting Craig at first. But I said something. He asked me a question the first time he met me. And if anybody knew him, he knew he always loved wrestling. Well, Stone Cold was my guy. He was an Undertaker guy. And the first thing he said to me was, "Wide," in honor, just like Stone Cold. And I just knew from then on, he was a genuine person, and you never had to question whether he wanted to be a part of something. If he wanted to be there, he was going to be there. If he wanted to do something, he was going to be there early, if anything. And it's just going to be hard without him. And a lot like y'all have said, I've never heard one person say anything negative about him. Ever. And I hope it stays that way, because Lord knows he's somewhere laughing at whoever's talking bad about him.
Oh, it really is kind of intimidating being up here. Hi guys, I'm Stormy. I met Craig probably 11, 12 years ago at this gas station that I was working at. And he always used to come to the drive-thru, and he'd be two Newport 100s and a Monster. And so that's how I remembered him. And I always thought he was pretty because I loved his hair, and he was cute. So I kind of flirted with him then, but nothing happened there. And 7 years ago, I started working at UPS, and I was lucky enough to be placed on his belt. And he recognized me, and immediately, he was just like a magnet. And from then on, Craig's always been my bodyguard. I work with a lot of men, so you can imagine a woman in the field of work we do. But he would always be my bodyguard, and everybody wouldn't talk to me because Craig would be mean mugging, and he didn't let nobody mess with me. But he is the only man in this world, other than my daddy, rest his soul, that has ever truly loved me. Y'all know him from a friend point of view, and or, you know, family. But I knew him as a lover. Craig took me as I am. I'm not easy to get along with. I'm the first to admit that. I would ask him all the time, "Well, why do you love me? Why do you love me?" But I never had to question it. I could see it in his eyes. From the way he looked at me to the way, like Dawn said, he rolled his eyes at me because I would get on his nerves. He was always on time and I was always late. So we were just a pair and a half. And we had our ups and downs. And, nobody's perfect, but that man was probably the closest thing that it comes to being perfect. He stood by me through both of my parents passing away, and my oldest son, his father got killed. And Craig was there. Craig always knew to give me space when I needed, and he knew when I was going to fall apart. You know, our job gets stressful, so I'd be like this close to just throwing boxes and cussing everybody out, and he would see it before, and he would just come get me and bring me down and let me take a break. He was just the most caring man I've ever had the pleasure to know. And I do thank you every day for you bringing him to this world, because he really was a pleasure. And it doesn't feel right, and I keep waiting on him to come back. And I know he's not, but I do know he's watching over us. And, yeah, but we love you, and I wouldn't always be here.
For y'all, those of y'all who don't know who I am, I'm Teresa. I was Craig's mother. I had the privilege of bringing that wonderful soul into this world. I had prayed for 12 years, gone to doctors, everything, to try to have a child. And they said I couldn't, that I'd have to have surgery before they could even think about me ever carrying a child. And I met Tony, wonderful man over there. And 6 weeks after we met, didn't know it then, but I got pregnant. I had no idea, didn't know what the symptoms were like, was told it could never happen. And I remember when I went, my sister Jackie was with me. We went back to Charleston because that's where I was living when me and my ex split up, and Tony's from there. And Jackie would come down with me, and she knew. And he was so crazy about her, too. She was his godmother. She quit a job, gave up an apartment, and moved to South Carolina when he was 3 weeks old just to be his nanny when I was working. But I prayed all those years for a child. And there's a saying, I don't remember it exactly word for word, it was on a tattoo, but I prayed to God for him, and I prayed for God to give me a man that would love me the rest of my life. And he did. I don't understand why he's gone so soon, but I know every moment that I had with him, even before he was born, I would rub my stomach all the time. And it got to the point when he was about 3 and 4 months old, Jackie and Tony could not put him to sleep. He wouldn't go to sleep unless he was up against my chest and I was rubbing his back. He had gotten so used to that in utero that he had to have it then too. But everything that everybody said is so true about Craig. You can't describe him. He was so protective of me, especially after Tony passed. But he was always that way. Craig actually saved me from being mugged in front of the gas station. Now it's, I don't know what it was. It's down there by the Kim's and stuff. It was a little convenience store. I went in, came out, was putting my wallet back in a purse, and a guy walked into me. Craig was only 15. He could tell, though, in the car, because we had the Durango, the windows were kind of blacked out, especially because their parking lot light was out. And I was standing here yelling, and this man's yelling at me, and I'm like, dude, you walked into me. What's the deal? And the next thing I know, I'm not kidding you, and for those of you who know me well, you've heard this, I just see a fist and an arm go right across my shoulder, caught the guy, cold cocked him, man
fell completely down. And I'm like, Craig, what did you do? Mom, get in the car. Mom, get in the car. Mom, get in the car. That's all he could say. Get in the car. We're getting out of here. And I'm like, what did you do that for? He said, Mom, that man had his fist balled up and was getting ready to swing on you. And I was like, oh. The next time that we went to see my mom and dad, which was probably the day after, my dad was a big hugger. Everybody that knew him or knows us, that's where Craig got it from. He got it from his grandfather and his father. But, sorry. But when we went over to mom and dad's the next day, Craig reached out like a hug. Dad put his hand out. And Craig thought he was in trouble. My father literally stuck his hand out and said to Craig, I want to shake the hand of the man who saved my daughter. And Craig never saw it that way, but my dad did. That he saved me from that. And the only times that Craig, when he was little, he got whipped twice. And both times was because he upset my mom and dad. I explained to him at a young age, that's your grandma, that's your papa, but that's my mommy and my daddy. So you got to be nice to them. And he understood it at a young age. And as soon as we left the house both times and got getting ready, he's like, I'm in trouble. And I'm like, yeah. I said, do you know why? Because I hurt your mommy and daddy. Imagine a two-year-old Craig saying that, or a three-year-old, and that's what he was. He knew, and he was very protective of everybody, something that Brittany doesn't know. No one else in the family knew. Brittany dated a guy when she was young, still in school. He became abusive towards her. Craig found out about it. He found out where he lived. He went in the middle of the night, got him out of his house, and beat the crap. I'll just say it that way. He beat that boy to death. I mean, he didn't die, but he let him know he was there, and he told him it was because of the way he treated you. So he was protective of all of us, not just me. I can look around at some of y'all and see faces. I know things that he's done for everybody. And I was so lucky to have him, even if it was only 31 years. It was the best 31 years of my life. I can never regret a moment of it. I just wish I had it longer, but God gave me my miracle. But I guess it was supposed to be short term that I would get him and then God would call him back. That's the only thing that keeps me going right now. And I appreciate all of you guys so much for coming out and being supportive of him. I don't know what else. He was just so wonderful. And he loved with all of his heart. And if he loved you, you were protected, looked after, whatever you want to call anything, for the rest of his life. He would. I mean, I can't tell you how many times people from UPS would call. Their car wouldn't start. They needed a ride. I got to go. Where you want? I'm going to go give somebody a ride home. Okay. That was it. I mean, people knew. Go ask Craig. If you have a problem, go ask Craig. And I did the same thing. But I appreciate all of you coming back, coming out. We have a room in there for refreshments and things. And I know some of you got your stuff right here. But I have other things that I need every person here to come up to see me because I have a gift for you from Craig. Okay? Thank you so much.
Some of these stories, I feel like we're a mafia family or something. You walk in the house, you give a hug and a kiss, and you... but don't cross us. No, I'm just kidding. But we can certainly remember Craig and all the good times. But it is still a bitter cup to drink from. And, you know, unfortunately, the bitter cup allows us to enjoy whenever the cup is sweet. And so in this time of difficulty, we can approach this in a couple ways, right? We can curse God, say, how dare you? How could you? We can say that he's unjust, unfair, uncaring, or unwise. But none of those things are true about the Lord. We can question God, which isn't as bad as cursing. It's okay to ask questions. I never want to communicate that. You know, we can question and try to make sense of the situation. But God has his perfect plan, his perfect timing. The third thing we can do is we can worship God. Worship him as good, as sovereign, as holy, faithful, just, the God of comfort, the God of peace, and the God who's in control. And I know by saying these things, I may upset some people, and I've been in that same seat. Because whenever my other brother died in 2009, the preacher man did the same thing. We had a great service, remembered Chris, and then he shared the gospel. And in my heart, I thought, how dare you? How dare you preach about your God at my brother's service? But now, and I'm sure many of you are surprised to see me here, those of you that knew me in my past, but now on the other side, how can I not say that there's such a good life in Christ? And that it's not about what we do, what we've done, our past, but it's all about what Jesus did on the cross. We're born sinners, and only Christ can pay the penance to make us clean. And so I hope you hear my heart in this. I don't know. I was there, but I don't remember what happened or why. Yeah. Craig was baptized at one of our family reunions by one of our great uncles. Yeah, he's our great uncle, Uncle Juddy. Yeah, you know, I love that Black Label Society song. I love the music of it. But the lyrics, you know, it doesn't all fade to black. Whenever we pass, we approach the doorway of eternity. And I don't want to preach a turn or burn sermon because that's not who I am. But what I would like to say is taste and see that the Lord is good. And that he is faithful and just and sovereign. So if I can leave us with a couple questions. What door will you approach when that time comes? What kind of legacy will you leave? And how will you stand before the Lord on that day? And I pray that in the grand scheme of life, you'll see how quick it truly is. Life is so short. And I hope that you enjoy every moment of it. And that you tell those that you love them. that you reach out to that person that you've been meaning to call. But ultimately, that you'll find your calling from the Lord. So if I could pray for us real quick, and then we'll adjourn. Lord, we just thank you so much for Craig, for him bringing us all together as friends, as family, for those of them that were coworkers, bandmates. Lord, and I thank you for the legacy that he left behind as a man of true character, as a protector, as a man who loved with his whole heart. Lord, I just pray for peace and comfort as we mourn this tragic loss. And in our time of pain, just remind us of your sufficient grace and give us the strength to just go about the rest of our days in love and honor to you. In Jesus' name, amen. Something that I did want to share, if you didn't get an opportunity to share up here, there is a room in the back beside the fellowship hall. We'll have a camera set up, and we would love for you to share a story, a memory, what Craig meant to you. So there's two options for people. One, I think Craig would love. It's a picture of Jason Voorhees from Friday the 13th. So there's that one. Or if this isn't your forte, there's another, and you just gotta pivot the mic stand. And there's a camera right here. And then there's pretty little black dots. And so, but we would love for you to share a memory, share a story, just so we can, you know, because it's just not possible for everybody to speak. And some people don't want to speak in front of others, but we would love to hear the stories you have, the memories you have, even just, man, we loved Craig, you know. So there's refreshments in the back in the fellowship hall. And everybody needs to come see her. So give us about 10 minutes before you go back there so we can get everything ready. Food-wise, get it out of the fridge. We don't want anybody to get a stomach bug from food sitting out for the last 2 hours. So, just hang out for about 10 minutes. We'll get everything ready. And then after everybody gets a bite to eat, we also plan to do a balloon release from the basketball courts in the back. We'd love for you to stay and be a part of that. We love you all so much. Thank you so much for being here today.